brought to you by Yogurt, an app that makes you write and perform.
By name, I'm a Malayali. I was brought up like a Marathi. But deep down, I guess I'm a little bit of a Gujarati. Unlike most who come from either one or two places, I come from a confluence of many states in this vibrant nation called India. When I meet people in my village, some accept me for who I am, and many view me as a stranger, disrupting the quaintness of their area with my funny city beast attire and a stilted take on the Malayali town. When I meet people in my city, the city of dreamers from lands far and wide, some accept me for who I am, and many view me as this disruptor, disrupting the rapid hyperactivity of my city with that accent they call Andukundu Thandapani. A phrase which, by the way, doesn't even exist in the five states of South India. People often romanticize the NRIs who left our homeland ages ago. The ones who are Videshi in their attire, but Desi at heart. Yet they rarely talk about the ones like me. The ones whose ancestors left their native places to make a mark in the big sprawling cities, the big concrete jungles of today. No matter where people like me go, be it our native place or the cities etched in our lives, we are always seen as the ones who are made on the margins, who are out of the margins made by the mythical leaders of our society. We are the ones who are in a no man's land. We are a lot less than what our native states demand us to be. We are not enough for the cities where we spend our rest of our lives in. We are the outliers who are destined to stay out of the boxes of crumbling homogeneity. It's time that people accept the fact, as days pass, as cities become closer, as borders begin to blend, there will be more of us and there'll be no turning back. Thanks a lot.